Hey, welcome back to the Six Figure Mastermind. Today, we're going to talk about how to set up a professional business PayPal account so you can start sending and receiving those transactions right away. Let's talk PayPal. You have a lot of options for sending and receiving money. PayPal's been around for a long time, you guys. Back in the day when eBay was like the thing online, PayPal was there. This is, you know, several years old. And it's one of the most reliable methods for sending and receiving payments. Now, again, you have a lot of options out there. I have several that I use. PayPal is just one of them. So let's walk through how to set up a PayPal account. So here's what I'm going to recommend to you. You've got another browser. I'm going to recommend that you open up another window, have it just side by side with this one so that you can walk through the steps right with me. We're going to show you A to Z how it's done. You need to have a few things for a PayPal account. You've got to have a bank account, and it's highly recommended that you have a credit card that you can attach to PayPal as well. So that if you're using your credit card, you know, it's your preferred way to pay, and people are taking PayPal, you can actually have the two talk to each other so that you can use your credit card. Maybe you get points or discounts or things like that with your credit card. You can actually set those two up so you can use your credit card. If, you know, maybe someone only accepts PayPal, you can still make that happen, okay? Here's a couple other cool things about PayPal. PayPal will link directly to your bank account. And if you're paying another person through PayPal, be it a business or a personal transfer, if you have the money come directly from your PayPal account and not using your debit or your credit card, you don't have to pay any fees and they don't have to pay any fees. Super cool. PayPal is also good for your business if you need to send invoices out to your clients. Just remember and keep in mind that PayPal, just like any other merchant account, does take off a processing fee, especially if there's credit cards involved. So if you're sending out an invoice to your customer, there may be a fee that PayPal takes off the top when that invoice gets paid. So be aware of that when you're sending those invoices. If you're ever using Eventbrite, and we have lots of videos put together for you on how to set up Eventbrite if you're doing events or anything like that, Eventbrite only uses PayPal as their main source of funding for sending you money and for receiving money. So if you're doing e-commerce of any kind, PayPal is going to be something you want to have in your back pocket, literally, on your mobile device too. PayPal here is a great tool to use. But let's just talk about setting up a basic PayPal account. There's several ways to do it. You know, you've got business, you got PayPal here. We're just going to go with the basics today. So you got that other window open? I hope so. Right over here, or maybe right over here. Okay, let's get this party started. So in that other browser, wherever you have it, maybe it's up here, maybe it's down here, wherever your favorite place is, go to paypal.com, okay, www.paypal.com. Let's go to my screen right here and check this out, all right? So if I go to paypal.com, I'm going to see basically this right here, okay? So if I have an account already, I'm not sure why you're watching this video, if you already do, because this is how to set up one, I'm going to click login. If you don't, you're in the right place because this is how to sign up for a PayPal account. Okay, sign up. Now, PayPal is really interesting because they only allow a single email address on a single account. Now, and I don't want you to be confused by that. This is what that means. A PayPal account can have multiple email addresses on that account. So if you have an email address that you're using for eBay, you can have it on the same account as, maybe you have a different email address that you use for Eventbrite. Both of those email addresses can be put on the same account. However, if you have an email address on one PayPal account, you can't have that same email address on another PayPal account. So one PayPal account can have several email addresses, but only one email address can be on a single PayPal account. You can't have multiple PayPal accounts with one email address. So one PayPal account, several email addresses, the email address can only be assigned to one PayPal account. Is that making sense? Okay, good. Go with me back to my screen. PayPal is a secure, easy way to pay and get paid. Sign up for free. Love it. That's what we're doing. Okay, we're going to go have a personal account right here. You can also set up a business account. That means you can set up invoices to your customers, you know, This personal account is just the basic one we're going to go with. Again, you can set up a business account. We'll show you that in just a minute. Okay, personal account. Next, let's just go on over here. I'm going to put in my first name and my last name. Don't use mine, use yours. And then I'm going to put a email in here. Let's do our business email because my personal emails are all used up. Okay, at gmail.com. I'm going to create a password. And I have to have a special character. And the passwords have to match. Perfect. Again, with your passwords, keep this very secure. Remember that this password is going to be tied to all your financial information, to your banks, to your credit cards, to your PayPal accounts. You don't want this password hackable, all right? So keep a password set aside just for the PayPal account that's not duplicated anywhere else, all right? I'm not gonna go ahead and stay logged in this computer. You can, if you're on your home computer, you can stay logged in for a faster checkout. That's totally cool. But I'm not gonna do that on a public computer. All right, and let's fill in our address. Now, I'm gonna put in a junker address because you don't get to know where I live and I'm okay with that. So we're gonna do 123 Main Street in No Name, Colorado. Believe it or not, that is a real city. And I'm not even sure what the zip code is there, but let's just put in one. All right, and we'll put your mobile phone number in there, okay? Let's do a 555-555-555. Great. Now, it probably won't take this one because it has a little sensor for junker phone numbers, and this is a real PayPal website, but you're going to put your information in there, okay? Okay, like this, you have read and agreed to the e-communication delivery policy. How many times do you check these things without reading them? Read this one, guys. It has your financial information. It has all of your bank and your credit cards attached to it. Please take the time to click on these and read these policies through and through, okay? You're giving PayPal lots of permission here. You want to know exactly what you're signing up for, okay? Let's see if this lets me create an account with this information. Guess what? It didn't like that. So because No Name doesn't match that zip code, let's set up one that I know does. Let's see if that works. Okay, perfect. All right, so once you've got your address and your phone number, everything filled in, it's gonna take you right to this page right here. You're in, what's next? Now you can send money and shop with ease with your new account. You can, you know, do that professionally or you can do that on a personal level. They also have lines of credit on PayPal that you can sign up for. That's a great way to use credit if you'd like. I don't have that personally because I have different cards and things that I use for that. So now we've got a personal account set up. Let's go back to the beginning and set up a business account. So go to paypal.com. If that's something that you need rather than a personal account, let's go back to paypal.com and set up that business account. All right, now we're back at paypal.com. Let's look at setting up a professional account. It works much in the same way, but there may be a couple of differences. So I'm going to go ahead and sign up right here and just click this little radio button, business account, and click next. Okay, now this one is a monthly fee account, the Payments Pro, there is a monthly fee. Payment Standard, that is free. Express Checkout, that's free. So you can select which one of these you want to do. The only difference, you check out these check marks right here, okay? Customize the checkout experience. That's the main thing you're going to get with the Pro account, okay? If you don't worry about that, if that's not a concern for you, then you can go ahead and select the standard one, which is free. You can accept all major credit and debit cards. You can accept PayPal payments. You can give customers the flexibility to pay over time, making payments if you like. Or you can do the express checkout. I would do the standard because you can accept credit cards with that, okay? Again, you can click any of these, learn more to learn more about the specifics of the account. Most of them you won't need to worry about. This is accepting the standard payments for the free account, okay? Okay, select standard. We're gonna click on that. It's gonna take us to a brand new page. You're gonna have to enter an email address. Now, remember what we said before. This email address can't be tied to any other PayPal accounts, all right? So if you have a personal account with this email address, you're gonna have to get a new business email address for this account. Now, I closed down my other account, so this should work. Okay, now let's put a password in. So you can create your own password, one that you know that you're gonna remember and not duplicate anywhere else. Or there is a Chrome plugin that you can use right up. If you look over in this corner right here, this is a password generator. So you can say, okay, what are the specifications that this website requires for passwords? Check all of these things. You can generate a password, boom. Okay, and Chrome will do its job and remember it for you, because there's no way I'm not gonna remember that, okay? So you can do that or use a custom password that you would like to generate on your own. So when you start your business, tell us about your business. Okay, this is the first name of the primary business contact for this account. This isn't your business name, okay? So we'll say Marianne. Of course, don't put my name, put your name. And legal business name. Now, that's me identical to the name on the company's articles of incorporation. Do not use a trade name or a shorter version of your business name. You can register your business online. In the state of Utah, it only costs like $22 to register your business as an official business entity, okay? Okay, we'll put in six-figure mastermind there. All right, I'm gonna put my real business information in there. We're gonna go ahead and have that blurred out because, you know, that's real info that, and you're gonna be using real info. So let's go ahead and do that. Perfect. Perfect. All right. Once you have all of your information put in there, please read the policies you're agreeing to. You're signing up for a free service. One of the biggest mistakes people make in social media or business, they will sign up for something for free and they won't know what they're signing up for. So please, please, please read these user agreements. I know it's going to take a little bit of extra time, but at least you'll know and be informed on what you're doing. After you've read them, please really read them. Click the checkbox and agree and create account. Okay, it's gonna ask a little bit about your business. So we're gonna say our business, you know, whatever your business is, partnership, corporation, whatever it is, business category, it just wants to know this for its demographics. We'll put education, business subcategory. We'll do business school. Estimate your monthly sales. You can put whatever your average monthly sales are in here. We'll just pick one at random, employer identification number. Now, if you are a corporation, you're going to have an EIN number, an employer identification number. If you are a sole proprietorship, you can simply use your social security number. So let's walk through the sole proprietorship. Again, it's going to ask you to put a business category in there and a business subcategory in there and a business URL if applicable. Okay, so put your website in there. Okay, so again, it's gonna ask for your social security number, your date of birth, your street address and everything. And personal contact. Okay, awesome. Okay, awesome. Once you've filled in all of your information, you're right here. Check this out. Welcome to your PayPal business account. You'll feel all official, right? Okay, so you're gonna have, how do you want to process cards payment on your website? Process all payments, including debit and credit cards through PayPal, or already processed credit card payments, add PayPal as another way to get paid. I would just click the left one if that's your situation. Of course, you can customize it. Okay, so this is your payment setup. How do you want PayPal to set up on a website? Option A, work with e-commerce solution that's already integrated with PayPal, or option B, add HTML buttons to your website yourself. It really depends on what website you're running. If you're running a blog or a website using Bluehost or Wix, they will have something set up for you that you can integrate with PayPal. If you're not using a platform that already integrates with PayPal, just use the HTML button. You can generate buttons as you need to sell products or classes or whatever you're needing to do. You can build a new button for each product and you can customize that. Absolutely. Okay, so we'll do option A. Already have one. You're gonna have to connect all of that, or you can click on option B to create buttons, or you can compare options, okay? So that's your payment setup. Your account setup, please confirm your email, make sure that's done. You're gonna go in and link your bank account. We're not gonna do that here. PayPal will walk you right through that. make your business name clear for customers, or you can get the PayPal MasterCard. You know, you can do any of those things. Basically, you've got your PayPal set up now. You've got your summary running. You've got everything ready to receive, ready to send payments. All of your activity, reports, tools, all of that information is right up here for you. But it's a very, very simple process to get your PayPal set up. PayPal will walk you right through the process. So, you know, get your PayPal set up. Remember what you're going to need it for, whether it's business or personal, and you'll be good to go. See, you got your PayPal account set up professionally for your business. So get some rockin' logos in there so you can start sending your invoices, bringing in some major big bucks, right? Hit the subscribe button and we will see you tomorrow.